One of the common questions when analyzing a slow application is if there are any slow database queries. You can of course monitor these queries on your database, but then you still need to match them with a part of your Java code. And because there's no easy way to see what happened immediately before or after a specific query, this can take much more effort than it should. Since Hibernate 5.4.5, you can also get this information from Hibernate Slow Query Log. Its integration into your application log can make your analysis a lot easier. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen, back with another video to show you how to build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring. Make sure to subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. As I explain in my logging guide, which you will find in the description and here, you should use two different logging configurations. One for production that keeps the overhead as low as possible, and one for development that provides you as much information about your application as possible. Hibernate Slow Query Log should be part of the development configuration, and you should adjust its settings based on the size of your test database. The smaller the database, the lower the threshold of your Slow Query Log should be. You can activate the Slow Query Log in your configuration in two steps. You need to configure the threshold above which Hibernate considers a query as slow, and Hibernate's logging configuration needs to include the slow query messages. Let's give that a try. The decision if a query is slow depends on lots of different factors, like the performance requirements of your application, the size of your database, your deployment scenario, and the available resources. You need to define this threshold for your specific application and test scenario. Using Hibernate Slow Query Log, you can define this threshold using the hibernate.session.events.log.logQuerySlowerThanMS property. If you're using plain Hibernate, you can set this property in your persistence.xml configuration. For a Spring Boot application, you can set it in your application.properties file by adding the prefix spring.jpa.properties to the property's name. When doing that, please be aware that Hibernate applies the threshold to the pure execution time of the query. This doesn't include any of Hibernate's preparation or result processing steps. Due to that, it's lower than the time reported in Hibernate statistics. After you define the threshold for slow queries, Hibernate will write a log message for each query that takes longer than the specified threshold. It writes this message in the info level to the category org.hibernate.sqlslow. So please make sure to configure your logging accordingly. Hibernate supports the slow query log for all types of queries. This includes JPQA statements, the criteria API, native queries, and the queries triggered by methods of the entity manager. In this example, I use the previously discussed configuration and execute a native SQL query that selects all author entities from the database. If the database takes longer than the configured threshold, Hibernate writes the following messages to the log file. The first line is part of the slow query log. As you can see, the database took this long to execute this query. In the second line, you can see a message from Hibernate's statistics component. Hibernate there reports a longer execution time. That's because the slow query log only considers the query's pure execution time, while the time measured by Hibernate's statistics also includes the result processing. As you have seen, you can easily activate Hibernate's slow query log in your configuration. Hibernate then measures how long it took the database to process each query. For each query that was slower than the configured threshold, Hibernate writes a message to the log file. This log configuration is very helpful to identify slow database queries within your application. Please keep in mind that the slow query log only measures the database's pure execution time. The time Hibernate takes to process the result is not included, but can have a huge impact on the overall performance of your query. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like cheat sheets and ebooks on how to use JPA and Hibernate more efficiently and avoid common performance pitfalls. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!